Everybody, welcome back to Falcon Plays Rimworld as we see these scurvy raiders run off after we got handed their asses to them just the last episode. Yeah, you guys run off and look at the carnage we caused over here. These are your fallen comrades that you guys are running away from. And you let it happen because you didn't stand by and actually fight. You guys fled. I guess, you know, smart on their part, actually. I can't really complain about that. I would probably fucking fly too out of here if I saw my guys falling like crazy. I saw all the guys lined up over here in crazy defenses. And all these fucking turrets just taking my people out. So I can't really complain about that, or I can't really, I guess, fault them on it, quite honestly. Now, there's a few things we gotta do right now. This is gonna be a little bit of a dumping stockpile for my weapons, by the way. I have gone out of my way to, as you can see, the brand. I mentioned I want to get this gun. I basically did this, which is highlighting all the brands in the map, or at least the ones that are from the raiders, and I basically put them as an X spot so that we are able to actually get... Oh, actually, there's four of them. Good. I want to keep those, I don't want to smelt those, I don't want to blow those up, so I'm going to put this as X's because I want to make sure that after we clean up, we know where they're at and we'll equip our guys with the Bren because it's actually one of the best weapons of all time, it seems. Other than that, we have to extend some of our defenses because, we have a lot more people now and not enough spots for them, so we do have to extend that a bit. And I also wanted to add one more turret, but I guess for now we'll just probably... These launch pads over here are what's kind of causing me from moving this downward a bit more, which is kind of a bit annoying, but... You know what I could do? Is actually, let me put a stone wall... Let's say... how do I want to set this up? I want to set it up similar to this one over here, which I kind of like. So let's do, stone wall... Here. Sandbag here. And then... Let's see. Do another sandbag there. Do a stone wall here. And then two sandbags. And I don't think anyone's going to be getting behind us. I don't need to put another one there. But that should pretty much be good. This will give me at least four more good spots for some of my shooters anyway. And I think that'll work out. Right? It should. Actually, if I put another sandbag here, I'll be able to actually put one, two, three, four, and five people. So let's just do that. Kind of like a weird little extension. Now... If this turret does blow up, it's going to risk these guys, but these turrets rarely ever blow up nowadays, considering our amazing defenses outside and everything. I'm not going to set the turrets out here just yet. I'm going to focus on them actually cleaning up the body so that we don't run into a situation like we did last time where my people were essentially... Why is there all this food around here? Why didn't you guys want to eat? James, are you going to eat? Yeah, James is eating. Alrighty. I guess I could give him a little table in there. Should I do that? Guess I could. I am not that completely heartless. Here's a fucking table, you scumbags. Here's a table for you guys, and you'll have that built soon enough. And should I even give them some chairs? I guess I'm just getting a little bit too kind in my older years, apparently. Where is a chair? All right, you dick lords. I'm gonna go ahead and give you a chair as well, so that you have somewhere to eat while you're over here arrested. There's some chairs right there. I guess I could put another one here and there. There you go, you dicks. You have a good dining area inside of your goddamn jail cell. It's not supposed to be this nice, believe me. This right here for them is a lot better of a situation than I live unrest. Oh, no. Oh, no. It's happening again, isn't it? It's happening again. Mental breaks everywhere. Oh, my lord. Oh, my lord. Alrighty, Daniel. You don't really want to play this game, Daniel. I assure you, you really don't, because honestly, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to build some beds before this gets too out of control. So let's just do this and this. Because I feel that this, we're kind of running into that situation right now. So Daniel, leave him alone for now. Let him cool off. And hopefully, he won't run off too far, but give him a second. I need my mental breaks to kind of calm down before I do anything too crazy right now. Okay, Tubes, you are going to be designated with capturing Daniel. He's going to go crazy when you try to capture him, Tubes, so just be aware of that. Yep, there he goes. Now he's gone nuts now. He's gone loco. Which one of these guys is not having that much of an issue right now? Jay seems okay. So Jay, let me, if I can, have you come and give us a hand over here. Because shit's about to go down right now. I'm not sure how many people are going to suddenly decide to give up on us, but it could be a few. It's starting to happen a lot now. I'm not sure why compared to before. Okay, so Tubes, let him down. He's gonna go crazy. Now you melee attack along with Jay. and just, oh no! Oh my lord. I guess the turret was like, fuck that, Falcon. If you don't have the balls to do what needs to be done, then I'm gonna do it. Okay. You know what? That turret has the right frame of mind. I'm sorry, guys. But I've had enough of you guys fucking giving up on the colony. So you know what? Good for you. Good for you, turret. You know what? You did what needed to be done. I'm sorry, Daniel. You are gonna serve as the, example over here as to what happens when, you start not playing by the rules. So, I'm sorry, Daniel. You are gonna go. I can't give Daniel a proper burial as well. I'm gonna have to burn him as well. Because you know what, Daniel? You fought this on yourself. Had you died in valiant battle for us, then okay, you could rest in peace properly and everything like that. You do not deserve to be up here. I'm sorry, Daniel. That's how it's gonna go this way around. This is a new era. This is a new Falcon that we're doing right now, and I've had enough of treating you guys well, and then this is how you pay me, by turning your back on me. So, you guys, mental breaks? Yeah, suddenly those mental breaks have gone down, haven't they? Alright, I'm telling you guys, if you turn code, it's over. This right here was the last bit of these guys that was gonna do that. You have it good, because you guys are safe, but next people that do it, I'm sorry, I don't care who it is. Well, if it's Batman, I might not do it, but, I mean, you know, my prejudice aside, well, not prejudice, but my bias aside, I should say, it's Batman. I can't really do that to Batman. So there goes Daniel. Shook's gonna put Daniel right there. I'm sorry, Daniel. This is your fault. Can't really blame anybody. You can't blame anybody but yourself. I'm sorry. You had the perfect life over here and you decided to give it up. Yeah, all of my mental breaks are now down, so that's good. It might kind of go back up now that we're actually putting these bodies in there, but we'll see. Hopefully, that's not the case. There's a lot more bodies to clean up this time, too. I just hope that, we get enough time to actually clean up the bodies this time around. Because it does make it a pain in the ass when the raiders show up and we have not finished cleaning up yet. Not to mention the fact that we also need to set up our defenses up here soon enough. But I'd rather get some of these bodies out of the way before we do that. We're not doing a good job as to getting our people back, though. Like, what's going on with our wardens here? Sid is a warden. He's only a 4, though. Funky? Funky's a really good talker. He's at a 6. Rose is a 6 as well. Well, I mean, I have a lot of good people talking to them, apparently. They're just not being recruited. So, yeah, I mean, it's not my people. I have a lot of... All of my high-ranked talkers are kind of trying to recruit these people, and they're just not down with it, so I can't really complain right now. It's them just not wanting to come in there. I might have to do a beating at some point or another. As a matter of fact, I probably will. You know what, Sid? Guinea. I'm gonna use Guinea as a prime example here as to what happens when under the new Falcon regime, what's gonna happen. This is what's gonna happen. We're gonna do a try to recruit, and we're gonna give him a mild beating. Alrighty. So I'm not sure who's gonna do it, but somebody's gonna give him a mild beating, and he better come around. That was not a beating, but I'm sure somebody will beat him up eventually. What do we have here? Xavier came around. Yeah, Xavier was like, yeah, you know what? We're talking killings and beatings now. I'm gonna probably join again. Good idea, James. Good idea. Shooting almost a 7, huh? Let me have you grab this, L, whatever the fuck that is. Now, my Brens are still kind of around. So, they completely are still around. So I'm keeping those for last, just so I don't, you know, ruin them by mistake here. So, Guinea, you're gonna be the first one to, take a beating, I thought. Doesn't seem like anybody's beating him up, though. Mild beating, try to recruit, yeah. Okay, we'll see. We'll keep an eye out over there. Bodies are just about cleaned up. Not just yet, but just about. So, oh, that's completely filled up over there too, so they can't really do much about that at this point. So, now that the last few bodies have been pretty much filled up, let me go and highlight these guys. Let me negate them for now. And we need Steven's burning self over here. Steven, let me move you on over to this side. And you are gonna do a lot of burning for us right now, which is good. Meanwhile, guys, don't move any bodies, but definitely there's still weapons to be picked up, I'm sure. Okay. So, Steven, you go on over here. Thanks a lot. And let me have you just chuck some Molotovs in there. Oh, look, Sid's over here beating up Guinea. So, Guinea, let's check out what's going on over here. Fear? Yeah, his fear's gonna go up now. Yeah, his loyalty's maxed out. He's happy as fuck. Well, he was after the beating, I'm sure. But yeah, look at that fear going up now, yeah. So, you know what? As long as we get that fear up and that happiness at the same level, he'll probably come around really soon. So, I'm sorry that we're gonna start doing this, but you know what, guys? I've had enough of being a nice guy and you guys just backstabbing me over here. So, Steven, thanks a lot for your burning. Good job. Mr. Zesty, 24% chance. So it does seem that the percentages are actually going up after that beating. So, Ginny took quite a beating there, but that's fine. His fear's about to hit that point that we needed that too, so... Now, Mr. Zesty, why does Ginny have to be the only one over here? Zest? Oh, Zest is almost there, but you know what? Zest, let me actually go and give this fucker a beating too. Alrighty. Do what you guys have to do at this point. I'm gonna pretty much let it go. No holds barred at this point. Alrighty, so these weapons are gonna be blown up, as you could imagine, just because I think everything is pretty much filled up, and our metal supply is almost at 45,000. How is our processing going on over here? It's going good. The thing is that we have nowhere to actually put this to because our areas are here filled up. So like, what I guess I could do is this right here will be the next area for raw resources, and we'll do this as a... what am I looking for? Metal, right? Metal, and we'll do that as a preferred, I suppose. Alrighty. And they'll start moving that over there. And there's another beating going on over there. Sid's over here beating the shit out of Ginny. Ginny, how's it going now? Yeah, your happiness is going down, that's for sure, but your fear's going up. So I'm sorry, man. Whatever it takes, it's gonna have to happen right now. Okay. Bodies are just about burnt up, meaning that we could pretty much put these as a go-again. So let's pick those guys up, and what we're gonna do now as well is, before we forget, is to set up our turrets over here just in case a raid's about to come down, so... Let's make this grabbable first and foremost, then we'll put a turret there, another one there, another one there, another one right there, and then we'll do the old sandbag method. It's actually been working out pretty good. I'm actually really happy with the sandbag situation because it keeps the raiders from using it against us, so... I'd like to say that I did this, I had an idea, that's what would happen, but it worked out pretty well for us though, where it kind of worked out better than I imagined it would, like setting up the sandbags there, and I was just lucky enough that when they blew up, it did indeed take all these sandbags around them with them, so I was actually quite impressed with my train of thought there, which is pretty good. Now, I could add another turret, obviously, make it a little bit more easier for us when they come in, but is that really necessary at this point? I don't think it is. Yeah, I don't think it really is, quite honestly. I wanted to put some in the corners, like I mentioned, but at the same time, it's just more stuff for us to build. I think this is more than enough as it is. By the time they get into the base anyway, they are pretty much already just about ready to flee anyway, so not really a big deal. I like how they're beating up Ginny while he's asleep. Well, he's trying to sleep anyway. So that fear is going quite up now. Prisoner was beaten, sharing a bedroom, wounded, imprisoned, beaten by the warden. Yeah, well, you know what? Whose fault is that, guys? You guys. You guys could have already joined us, but no, you guys want to make it difficult to just get recruited and come back to the colony, so... You have nobody to blame but yourselves. Are all the weapons picked up? Yeah, just about all of them but the Brens, and, well, we're gonna give the Brens to my best shooters, obviously, just because, you know, I guess they get the most out of it. So, Bob, let me have you, sir, equip the Bren. And let's see, who is my other good shooter? Would probably be BFD, wherever he might be. BFD, wake your ass up, or yeah, I guess I don't have to recruit you, honestly, but let me have you go and equip this Bren. And there's four of them, there should be four of them, there's another one down here. So the other one will go to, him too is, did I wake, no, him too is a good shot, right? Actually, no, Melting Ked's a 13, if I remember correctly, so Melting Ked would probably get a really good kick out of that. So, Melting Ked, where did you go? I'm not sure where you went. What? Alright, Batman, you go and grab yourself one as well. Melting Ked, where have you run off to, my man? Cat, 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 cat. Cat, if you don't want this gun, I'll give it to somebody else. I'm sure anybody else would want to rock the, Oh god, I went a key already. For some reason, when I try to click on a person, it goes up one. I think it might just be due to the fact... Oh, by the way, there's some rooms over here being used. I could turn that on. Why isn't this on? Connected raid zero. Oh, what? Why are those connected? Huh. That's interesting. Shouldn't that be connected to this? Or no? They're just kind of hanging out there for no reason? That doesn't make any sense at all. Oh, they're connected to that door instead of this one. Well, that's just silly. That's just completely silly. Alrighty. Well, that's interesting. I guess what we could do is just, deconstruct the door? Would that make it easier? Let's deconstruct the door, and maybe then the thing will connect to the one that actually has power running through it. Ugh. Alrighty, and where is Ket now? Apparently, I can't highlight Ked by myself, so I have to go find him manually. Melting Ked. There you go, man. You go and equip this one over here. Good. So that's pretty good. We're going to have some of the better weapons equipped on our best shooters, so that's going to work out for us quite well. You can run off now. BFD. All right, good. And there's only a few more bodies left to kind of pick up and throw in there before we are ready to go. Another beating was taking place, I think I heard. Okay, so let's see. Loyalty is max, happiness is max, fear is up. Good. Okay, so Guinea's the one that's losing happiness really quick. But you know what, Guinea? That's your fault. You could really end this right now. If you guys want to end this, you definitely can. You just have to allow it. Okay, and my defenses are going to be pretty much up and running now for the next raid, which is good. A few more weapons getting picked up, and there's a few more bodies to remove, and then we'll be good to go. I'm really excited what's going on right now. I'm really going to be upset to let this base go because I feel that we have everything good and running. But at the same time, it also does make sense why we have everything good and running, because the base has pretty much already hit the obsolete point where it's just kind of like, well, at this point, you just kind of go in from raid to raid. Alright, so I'm gonna do that right there. Okay. Zesty. Fear is almost maxed out. Happiness is going down really, really fast for Guinea. So now that we've done some beatings, I guess now maybe it's probably a good time to do the friendly chats again. that's basically me playing good cop, bad cop in a way. Give you a mild beating for a while and then be like, alright man, I'll come back around and be like, alright guys, so this is gonna go on, this is gonna continue going on, you guys could end this by letting me recruit you. And, hopefully now they've seen the errors in their ways and they'll stop. And meanwhile, Steven, you could come over here, my friend, and burn a few bodies for us because we are done hauling bodies away. Don't arrest anybody, just move over there. Okay, and my guys have the Brens equipped and everything's good to go, and blasting charges is set up over here, so if we can, make sure nobody's running through there first and foremost. Let me set this up and blow up some of these excess weapons that we don't need anymore. I really would have liked to set everything off, but okay. Okay, good. There's still a few more left, that is for sure. So what I could do now is just delete all of this. And all of this, so that he kind of round up everything together right there. We failed to recruit Guinea again. 14% chance. Okay, Guinea. Guinea's not going to make it easy for anybody, it seems. So, Steven, you go and move in here and launch that Molotov in there. And a few down over here as well, if you may. Don't knock it against the wall, though. Oh, you can't. So, do it in there. Another one. Okay. And that should just about do it, I want to say. Yeah, totally. So, you are good to go, Steven. Thank you for your work. Run off now. He's one of our best incinerators of all time, it seems. Okay, and then these weapons are the ones that are left over. And I suppose now I could probably do a blasting charge. Oh, that's going to work out quite well. Right there and there. We'll blow those up, and we'll be good to go. And then everything's good. We've picked everything up. We've dealt with all the bodies. We're beating up our prisoners now just to teach them who's boss. I might even put a gibbet cage in there to inspire a bit more fear. How about that? We haven't done that in a while. I mean, I'm going to need a body for that for sure, but... you know, do I even have gibbet cages still? Is it a structure? You know what? I think I might have removed gibbet cages and never use them. No, no, they're there. Gibbet cage. Alrighty. The gibbet cage there and there. I'm telling you, this is like Mad Max style at this point. This is what they've pushed me to do, though, because they don't want to join back, even though they have an amazing thing going on over here. Now, let me just quickly set this blast charge off. Nobody run through there, or else you're going to die. Good. Excellent. All right, this is a good episode. It's completely, completely rounding everything up. We have everything cleaned up just about. Metal everywhere. Everything is good to go in the base. I am really digging the base right now. Again, I'm going to be really heartbreak to let this go because we have the ideal utopia going on over here. Complete with the beatings and everything. Now, the next time we kill a few raiders, I'm actually going to burn all of them. I'm going to keep three bodies around so we could kind of put them in those gibbet cages. I almost feel like digging up some of these bodies over here. Bro kick. Raw awesomeness and crabs and putting them in those gibbet cages. Just to make it look that, you know... it's going to inspire more fear, I think, because it's like Falcon doesn't even care anymore. He's willing to put the bodies of his old colonists on display to strike fear. Should I do it? I don't know. I'll leave it up to you guys. How about we call it an episode here today, guys? I think everything went pretty well today. I can't really complain about it. Really good. So overall, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, let me know about how you feel about this new beating system and whatnot. Do you want me to come back with an iron fist, or do you want me to keep doing the kind-hearted overlord type of thing that we've been doing the whole time? And this is how they've traded me back for it, by turning code on me. Either way, guys, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I'll catch you next time.